let us have on the top line,
yeah,
flute, clarinet, and oboe. On the middle line, let's go both, or all trumpets, horn, all saxophones, and clarinet two. Oh, clarinet one on top line. And on bottom, here's where it's going to get a little interesting. Let's see. Trombone and bassoon. Could I get you guys to play the top line of the, or the top line of the bottom? And euphonium, bass, clarinet, and tuba, if you could play the bottom line. Alright?
Squeeze up just a little bit. Practice against the wall like we did the other day. And maybe lay on the ground on your back and feel grounded, and then against the wall, and then away from the wall, just so that you keep that really nice posture. And you can do that in front of a mirror.
Alright.
Did you hear anything interesting at the very beginning of the piece?
They seem to start a little bit behind.
Okay. Well, we had some wrong notes happening in the cornet section over here.
It's okay.
Hi, now, Justin, you have a wonderful demeanor. Everybody likes you a lot because you're a really nice guy. Okay. So I don't think you're welcome, and I don't think you have the ability to offend anyone. Not that you'd ever want to, because I don't think that you would. You respond to things that you like. We also want to see you respond to things that you don't like, and respond in kind is what Elizabeth Dean says. Respond in kind. So that the response keeps everybody in the mood of the music that's happening at that moment in time. All the responses that we have as a conductor should be in kind. Okay? Right. So let's try that again. So respond more to what you hear and try to effect more meaningful change. Okay. So go stand against the wall and put your head against the wall. And here we go. They can see you. Okay. Nice and relaxed.
Thank you.
accepting is the part that most people have the hardest part with, which is the right hand. The right hand is beautiful. The baton is beautiful. You're conducting from the tip beautifully. Put the baton down.
Right.
Put the right hand in your pocket. And conduct only with your face and your left hand.
Alright.
Beginning. No beats allowed. No beating the music. Assisted left hand is all you need to show for more of a crescendo. None of this kind of thing. Okay.
Right.
Consistent left hand. And again. But we already see better face because your eyes started to become more energized, which is very good. Your eyes are the gateway to the soul. Thinking, okay, what are you going to do now, to becoming really comfortable and trying some things and listening. It was really cool. Okay? Comments, please.
Don't forget that a good release is like a downbeat instead of a metal.
So like Dr. Ross said, like we definitely know when you like what you see, like by your facial expressions. And one thing that you can kind of think about as far as like even expanding on the positive side of it, but also like showing whether you don't like it, it's like if you think about like when you're walking through the grocery store and you see a baby, like if they're happy, you can see it in their face. And if they like, if they just ate a lemon at a restaurant or something, like you can see everything on their face. It's a little extreme, like don't do the facial expressions as a baby does, but if you think about how completely bold and honest they are in their faces and try and portray that.
And immediate.
Will do, thank you.
Your comment.
I feel like you're always trying to make eye contact with us, which is a good thing, but I don't feel like your eye contact always has meaning. So whenever you do make eye contact with someone, try to give it some meaning, make some contact, and that was really redundant, so sorry. But have a conversation, like I said that before. But make sure we know what you want, what you like, and what you don't like. Don't glaze over us just to get your head off score.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, your confidence is great. I mean, from the tip of the stick is great. What I would start developing a repertoire here. I mean, lob and movement theory. Alan McMurray is wonderful with this, but partly because he studied mime. And so he's like, something like this can be a crescendo. And this can be a decrescendo. It's just whatever you want to make it. And doing exercises like this. Changing pattern. And then doing. Because, and we saw a lot of this today, is people have these musical ideas, but you have the elevator.
Which is very common.
Which is all right. So do something like this. Then you're going to start developing fluidity here, and you can start doing different things, and you get different sounds. This gives you a different crescendo than this does. So figuring these things. I'll put on a scan of a book that I have. It's A Conductor's Guide to Lob and Movement Theory. And it's all about, like, the press, the flick, and all these different kinds of things, and it's ways to think about different gestures to get different sounds. So I'll put that up there this week.
Very good. And thank you guys for posting the posts that you do for the conducting class. I hope you guys are doing the readings. I was just at Leesville Road High School, and I've got a couple more things to post just to show you how a band director thinks and plans for things, okay, which are very, very good. Nice job. Thank you very much. Awesome. We will start next time with